I didn't know that. That's actually really good information. It's actually pretty important.
And he's just like, I don't know, I'm a tough dude.
Okay.
Okay, probably Q first. I can't imagine.
No, you're gonna get W first in the jungle.
Okay.
No, I'm kidding. My god.
Dude, it's too late. I got W. I skilled W.
Wait. No. Did you?
No.
I would have fucking believed it. Okay. Holy shit.
Alright, what's my skill order gonna be, though?
Q, W, Q, E,
okay.
Q, R, Q.
Q, W, Q, E, Q, R, Q.
Yes.
Okay.
Now, all of his skills have attack animation resets, so take that into consideration.
Okay.
Alpha Strike can dodge literally anything as long as you time it correctly.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Do you know what his W actually does? I know
it
you know it's a heal.
You.
Yes, but do you know what else it does?
It reduces incoming damage by 50%.
Okay.
And 25% against turrets. I'm assuming I can do a full clear without backing, and that's what I want to do.
No, that's not what you want to do.
You're
only going to use one potion, and you're going to activate it at red. If you want to be really ballsy, you don't have the right rune mastery set up, so don't even try it. Just make sure that you smite Cromps.
Okay.
Did you? Please tell
yes,
me you
did. Yes, I did.
Okay. You want to smite it as soon as you had started attacking, because you don't want to make waste of the passive.
Yes.
Okay, I get W, use it. Nice, perfect. Great. Why did you stop it prematurely? You had 30 HP to go. Don't do that, man. That's really big. Try to time your Alpha Strike against the Red Golem's attack so that you dodge it.
Okay.
But before you do that, pull back a little bit so that the minions' HPs don't reset at all.
Do I go after these toucans?
You auto-attack them all once, and then you Alpha Strike. The fuck? How did you get another W?
Okay, I back after two cans, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I pick up Stalker's Blade or Trailblazer?
You actually could have done Gromp, I'm sorry. Pick up the Trailblazer, but you're not gonna finish it. Like when you finally do go to upgrade it into the tier 2 or whatever, you'll
mm-hmm.
get the blue one.
Yep, that's what I've been doing.
Okay.
When I do have to jungle.
Yeah, just get it. Go to blue. You're gonna smite Gromp and do blue, and then you're gonna go to dragon.
Okay. Not even killing Gromp, just taking the passive from it, right?
Yep. Okay. No, you can kill Gromp because you're mastery.
Okay, so kill Gromp and then go to blue.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't sure what the timeline you wanted.
But smite Gromp last. Like, when Gromp finally gets to 430 HP, then smite him so that you make absolute use of him. Too late? Yep, too late.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
You should always be healing. Don't open with Alpha Strike. No, don't do that. Always auto before Alpha Striking. You save HP.
Okay.
Unless it's, like, irrelevant.
Okay. I'm level 3. I go to Dragon now?
Yep.
Okay.
You can kill Scuttle Crab and you'll get level 4.
That's what I figured.
It's all planned. Oh, no. You have to kill the... Shit. I fucked up. I'm so sorry. You have to kill the two small wolves.
Oh.
I forgot. I'm sorry. It's my fault. You can still do Dragon, though.
Okay, kill the scuttle first, I'm assuming.
You walked through mid, though. I don't know if you got any XP.
No.
Okay, yeah, kill the scuttle first, of course. Make sure that your W is off cooldown before you start dragon.
Okay. What's my plan of attack for the Strike?
Use Alpha Strike to dodge its attacks, and use W every time that it's up. Like, to dodge an attack, but also reduce the damage. And always use E. Go. Always stay inside the Dragon Pit so you don't get knocked out by the knockback. Always turn on E. Keep E on. Pop a potion as well. Nope. Time your alphas better. You don't need to move. You don't need to move. Just stand still. Time your alphas to dodge the fireball.
Okay.
Okay. Nope. Now W. Oh, fucking Christ, Italy. Do you die? No. Okay. I don't know why that's worded. That's okay, though. That's okay. Just go and do it. Just go and do a camp. You're going to be fine.
Okay. Okay.
Oh, did you get dragon?
No. It just reset. Oh, I don't even know what I'm doing.
You could have elf.
Okay!
What just happened?
I just got a kill on Ziggs.
Okay.
Yeah, I think you just saw it.
Yeah,
I'm sorry, I don't know, I've...
Like, no, it's okay, I know, you said really you haven't played him before, which is okay.
This is cool, though, I think he's a good champion to learn with. Same vein as Kayle.
Well, he has some things that are, they're very micro-oriented, like split-second, like, you know, dodging the fireball with Dragon. You know what I mean? Doing that every single time is, it. You know, like, there are some people that just won't. You know, like, their reflexes are, like, whatever, like...
Yeah.
It's good. So. Anyways, sustain in the jungle until level 6. Oh, I guess I forgot to tell you to take teleport, but that's okay.
That's fine. So I have... Oh, I don't have level 6 yet, damn. Okay.
No, never look at lanes on Yi. Nope.
Yeah.
Don't do that. If your screen even shifts the jungle.
Okay.
No, I'm kidding. Like, look at lanes, but don't ever, you know, like, when you're looking at them, you kind of have to be watching a movie, you know, like, oh man, that really sucks. Like,
yeah.
I wonder if she's going to get the guy in this episode, you know, like, you can't. Yeah.
Do I want to take red here, or do I want to just wait till I...
You want to utilize red, so don't get it yet.
That's what I'm thinking.
Yep, always make use of the golem's passive. Before W-ing, you should have killed them. Like,
yeah.
Otherwise, you...
I think I took the always W when it's off cooldown, too, literally.
Yep.
Okay, I got level 6. I'm gonna get my Stalker's Blade with Warrior Enchantment, I'm assuming?
Chilling.
Yep. Which one? The Brutalizer thing?
No, Devour.
Okay. And now what do I do?
You just keep farming. You look for opportunity now, though. Keep farming, look for opportunity, go to lanes, press Q, feel good. This is why you need teleport, though, on you. Like,
yes,
I guess because you're running flash, you do have to gank a little bit more than normal, but it'll be okay. If the big delay is still present, then tell me stuff that may be going on.
Okay. I think I might be able to get something done bot. Mm-hmm. They're low and sticking around.
Oh, yeah, then, yeah, definitely.
Nasus is still here, though.
Yeah, who cares? Go. He can't wither you if you have ultimate, because he can't be slowed. True. Yeah.
Yeah, I missed my chance. I was looking at Nasus too much. Okay.
Oh, no, that wasn't Nasus being mid. That was him killing Scuttlecrab. 100% you kill Graves and Vel'Koz there.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, did Ziggs kill you?
Yeah, that was really silly because I showed bot and I could see that Ziggs was missing.
Yeah. But the other thing is that you could have W'd his ultimate.
Oh, yeah. It just, I don't know. It caught me by surprise, to be honest.
It's okay. Go get blue, get Gromp, etc. Now, Yi, like, how much have you ever played him, like, in your life?
Less than 5 times, probably.
Okay. So he deals lots of damage. like, you'll be very surprised once it occurs, but, yeah.
Okay. I've played against him. Like, I know he's... I shouldn't have started with Elfstrike
there. Your smites should only be used on Wraiths... Wraiths and Krugs. You don't want to use it on Gromp the later the match goes. Because it doesn't have utility because you blow everything up anyway.
Gotcha.
Remember, you can't be slowed by Gnossus.
Probably boots next. Circuit Greaves.
Why did you flash?
I don't know.
He wouldn't have caught you. Remember. It's okay. boots, yeah, Berserker Greaves. And then you'll go into Blade of the Ruined King.
Okay.
Always get a red potion. Skittles. Ult! No! Look, your ult is on such low cooldown, and the way that Yi operates, just, like, literally just fucking turn it on anytime you see
it. Yeah, you just use it to hunt people down?
Well, just turn it on. Like,
okay.
With Yi, you need more disrespect than Pantheon. Like,
that's a lot of disrespect.
And when you kill them, you need to let them know how skilled you are, because you're picking Yi and pressing 2 buttons, okay? Like... You need to let them know that it takes a lot of effort to press Q. Alright? Okay. Fucking Azir main at Challenger? No. How about Master Yi at Silver, okay? Like. Fuck Vel'Koz up, did you? I saw you put on the hunt. You didn't smite first, though.
Yeah. I could have Alpha Striked a lot of damage there, and I would have lived.
You would have... Yeah, see, you gotta learn to learn, like, you gotta learn to embrace the Alpha. Like...
Yeah.
Have you watched Cowsap montages?
Not really.
We're gonna watch it together on screen, okay?
Like, okay.
We're gonna do that right after. We're gonna watch a Cowsap montage. Like, now comes the time where, like, okay, so you've gone from gold 5 to platinum 2 in, like, a month and a half, right? So,
yeah.
Just get into diamond, you know what I mean? So that you can get over the cognitive bias that you're subconsciously probably having right now. You know what I mean? So just get into diamond 5 and just, like, fucking use Yi to do that or something. Like, if you have to play jungle.
Okay.
Because literally he will just face roll the ever-loving shit out of fucking everyone. Because the team coordination and everything is so low at this point, and because junglers don't have a proper idea of CS and XP rotations in relation to, like, their carries or something, you'll end up having, like, 120 CS when the enemy jungler has, like, 40. And, like, that speaks to itself. Yeah, get there! Turn on... You let Riven die! That's triple kill. Triple kill, triple kill, triple kill. Triple kill, triple kill. Go! No! Triple kill! This thrash! Stop suiciding, you fucking clown. What a fucking poet. What a goddamn poet. You click more jungling Yi than you do with your laners.
Dude, are you not the one who told me that Yi is a difficult jungler to use?
He is, actually. The higher you go, the higher you go, he does be- Double kill! What? Double kill! Triple quadra kill! Your E, you deal true damage. I need a moment.
Alright, take all you need. I'm enjoying
What the fuck? I didn't say I need to die.
This is entertaining for me.
I'm gonna come back as a fucking skeleton, like, you tell me to take all I need. No, I'm kidding. Oh my god.
Like, I really don't have much of an idea what I'm doing, but I'm enjoying it, so. Okay.
Your E deals true damage, you know that, right?
Yes.
Okay, all your autos deal true damage. So that's why Gnosis doesn't matter. Like, gotcha. Gnosis only matters when his Q kills you. But even then, eventually, you'll hit a point where, like, your autos are just, like, faster than his CDs. Okay. Just push a lane now. Now you have to embrace Yi.
Okay.
Where you mute your teammates, and you only split. Need 500 gold. No. Don't take the W so literal now as the game approaches. You know what I mean? Like,
yes.
Be looking to make efficiency out of your movements.
Okay.
W is pretty time consuming.
If I'm split pushing, do I want to,
just keep your mana above 300.
Okay.
So you can alpha strike if you're above that.
Yep, I was just wondering.
Oh, go, double kill. Why are you waiting? Go, smite! Go! Yeah! How's it feel to be Yi? How's it feel to press Q? How's it feel?
I'm so talented!
I know you are. How's it feel to press
I'm also not normally a jungler, so Smite's range is kind of deceptively long right now.
Oh, it's really good, right?
Yeah, they're nerfing it next
You like
patch,
that, so, fuck you. You like it, right?
I do like it if I'm playing Yi.
Holy shit.
Is there blue up? No, it's not, because I have it.
Oh, man. Oh, feels great to be Yi.
Oh, shit. I'm noob.
Did you miss? What? Oh, fuck. Oh, man. This is your first time playing you?
Yeah, great. Ever since, like, bronzers, ARAMs and crap like that.
That's great.
Die, Nidalee. You have no place here. You want some Ziggs?
Alright, you need to recall, though, and get Bork. Oh, yeah, Nidalee, she stepped out of line. You need to show her 50 shades of Yi. 50 shades of Yi, and then there's, like, the sequel, 50 shades of me. Like,
is that really a thing?
I don't know, it is now. Fucking, oh, man.
Alright, what's my next buy after Bork?
After Bork, with how this game's going, Yumu's Ghostblade.
Okay. Next objective is probably keep pushing up bot.
No, and now you push top.
Okay.
You show Gnosis what it means. Fuck. One for ones are not good at this stage of the game. No, really? Okay. Thank you.
All right. RIP.
Also, never, like... Oh, remember, by the way, to use Bork. It is essential... Okay, like...
Okay.
I don't know why Riven's still top with you, though. Like...
I'm not sure either.
I guess you'll raise the tower pretty quick, but...
Yeah.
Like, by the way, you know about how if you smite Gromp and then you auto-attack a tower, it deals, like, a shitload of damage?
You mean the Krugs, right?
Yeah, the Krugs. Gromp, Jesus Christ, yeah. Krugs.
I'm so talented!
Why did you get... How did you... Tell me about it. Tell me how talented you are.
I'm the most talented player.
Okay. Tell me about it. Did you press Q?
I did.
Twice or three times? Like, how talented?
I had to press it, like, three times.
Three? Wow.
Yeah. I just got plus six, though, so it's not
That's
so
hard.
Hard.
That's really hard. Tell Less me, rough. Did you press it, like, a fourth time?
I tried to, but then NASA...
No? Okay.
...showed me the cane.
All right.
I let him have this one, okay. So he doesn't, like, surrender.
It's alright, you're more skilled. You pressed it. I heard you pressed Q, like, three times, so. Oh, fuck. No. Why'd you buy Ghostblade? Buy Avarice, hold on to it, you spawn, then you buy Ghostblade.
Oh.
It's, like, really minor, but whatever.
Yeah. Okay. I think that got me half a gold at best.
No, but if, like, you have, like, a 40-second death timer and you're holding it, then...
Yeah, I gotcha. Okay, so all their inner and out... Oh, there's one outer turret remaining. I think I know what to do.
You're learning. Okay, yeah. Turn on E while you're during alpha. You also didn't turn on Yumu's. That's pretty big.
Yes, it is.
Let's kill the wolves.
Does...
Oh, you gotta remember your actives. By the way, why is your blade on 3 and your Yumu's on 6? Is that how your finger is positioned? Because you really haven't used the actives too much. Makes me a bit scared next time I see you with Zhonya's, like...
No, normally I have...
That's okay, impressive. Subconsciously, you seem to know how your alpha strike's gonna work against minions.
I think I've just been face rolled by too many Yees. It feels good to be on this end.
No, you could have killed Vel'Koz. Because remember, like, the turret would go to hit you, but then you would alpha.
Oh, right. Yeah, I've had that happen to me a lot, too.
Oh, fucking kill. Yeah, see? It's okay. Whoa. Sometimes you go a little too deep, you know? It's like... It's like you're on the Jenny Craig diet, but then, like, you get a Pizza Hut coupon.
Yeah, I think that just happened. Fuck. I got too excited.
Did you? Yeah, you can't kill Gnossus without all your stuff being up.
Yes.
If all your stuff is up, Gnossus will die. 100%.
Okay. That's what I'm thinking. Alright, next item is?
Let me see their items. Still can't see. The fuck?
Wow. This delay is...
Oh, okay. It's up. Get Bloodthirster.
Okay. Having E on during Alpha Strike?
It doesn't do anything. Nope.
Okay. I'm going to be honest with you, I have not read a single word of this chat that my team is saying.
Yeah, that's good. You're really embracing E then. Holy shit.
Okay. I'm actually kind of pissed at Kat. She killed them all before I could.
Okay. The hunt is on. Oh, you got a dove. You didn't turn on Yumu's. That's why you're moving so slow.
Right. Yep,
that's
yep,
really
yep.
big, you know?
It is big.
Is that what she said?
Depends on which she you're talking to.
Okay. Alright.
I don't know.
Oh, that was actually really good. By Riven.
Yeah, she's almost as talented as me.
Yeah, almost. She has to press, like... She has to press two buttons, though. You know? Like...
That's I think, cool. really, how good you are is measured by how many buttons you have to press.
Yes.
The lower is better.
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's really skilled when you just have to not press anything and auto someone.
Mm-hmm.
Like that's when you know you're good.
Okay. I think Baron would actually be a reasonable objective.
Yeah, but I mean, the game's technically over.
Yeah, I guess we could just push on mid.
Yeah. We could actually, like, you could open up a game of Hearthstone right now and win the fucking game. Holy shit. This fucking Thresh, no reason to risk Baron. He's the type of fucking asshole that would fold, like, quad aces when the only thing that can beat him is, like, a straight flush. He's like, no need to risk my money here. Okay? Like... Oh my god, it's actually a risk not to do Baron. That's so funny. I mean, it's more riskier to not do Baron. Do you understand why?
It's riskier to not do Baron?
It is riskier to not do Baron, yes.
Well, I think it's just free right now.
Well, it's not even... Never mind. Thresh is literally Challenger.
Oh, shit.
This Thresh is every single one of those people that read How to Climb Challenger. Or how to climb LO on Reddit. Did you die with Yi?
Yeah.
Yeah, this call's over. Like.
Yeah, I don't know. I let them have a kill, feel good about themselves, help their fantasy LCS points.
Okay. Oh, that's all right, man. It means you're a nice person.
Yeah. All right, so going back to the Baron. Mm-hmm. I feel like it's better to take it because it's free, so it's sort of like, why not? Mm-hmm. And it makes it so that when you inevitably push March to the Sea, like, there's nothing that can stop you.
Well, it's not even about that. It's that if, for some reason, you coin flip a fight inside of their base and they beat you, they then also get Baron.
Ah, that's so smart. Yeah.
So it's denies, like, it's reducing...
It denies them.
Right. Yeah. There was some fucking quote I learned when playing poker. When I was learning poker for the first time, I don't remember what the exact quote is off the top of my head, but it was something that Kaizen Master told me. It was basically something like, basically you, like, it had something to do with luck, right? And mm-hmm. how the biggest way to prevent it is to make sure that it cannot occur.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? I can't
yes.
remember it off the, ah, fuck, dude. I hate feeling mental blocked. It, like, makes me so frustrated. But basically, like, you take Baron there just because you reduce all chances.
Yes. No,
you know, it's kind of like
I totally get what
Murphy,
you're saying.
Murphy's Law, right?
Totally, totally.
Anything that... No,
yep.
wait. Yeah.
Right? Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's
yeah.
Murphy's Law.
Anything that can go wrong will go wrong.
Yeah, exactly.
So,
okay, there you go. There
assuming you fuck up the team fight, cover your bets, make hedge your bets, make sure that they can't also get Baron in addition
yes,
to that
yes,
tempo
yes.
swing.
Okay. Okay, let's go over the VOD really quick together.
Sure. I still, like, that game is sort of a blur. I was just doing what you told me to and trying not to feed.
Okay. Alright, so let's, hold on, I gotta message the owner really quick. Stop the recording. Watch. Okay, so I'm gonna share screen with you. We will watch the Cowset montage together.
Okay.
Okay. Any questions that stand out, you'll ask me. Okay, so let me pause your stream.
Okay.
Jesus, that didn't pause it, that opened it in another browser. Okay. Pause that stream. Okay. We're gonna pause this, okay? And then we're gonna open up you're just gonna watch it on my stream, okay?
Okay.
So we're gonna
not through share screen, through
yeah,
your
we are.
Twitch stream?
We are.
Okay. No, okay, okay, okay.
Cowsep. Two months ago. Okay, million views, holy fuck.
That's a lot of views.
That's a shitload of views, wow. Okay, can you see?
Yes.
It's very interesting, this montage, like, if you watch it slowly, it says everything he's doing as he does it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, see? R Highlander, use Ghostblade, dodge with Q. It takes you through it. So, in a way, this is coaching. Do you see the level of disrespect?
Yeah, what is this? He just walks in there and kills them.
Yeah, exactly. You need to learn this.
You shouldn't be able to do that.
Oh, watch this.
That's broken. Okay, that's pretty cool.
That's right, yeah. It's pretty good. Twisted Fate messed up, though.
How did he mess up?
You just keep, like, you don't lock the card. You just keep auto-attacking E and throwing Qs until he goes onto you, then you lock.
Right, but what if he just never Alpha Strikes, doesn't Master
Yi beat Twisted Fate? It's a leveling game. Like, leveling is a terminology in poker. Used to describe, like, mental plays. This is really impressive. On Ari and, that's pretty impressive. Like, if you're in the game, it's not that impressive. To the average viewer, it looks really, really impressive, but if you're actually playing Yi there in the game, it's not that difficult to dodge that charm. A lot of the stuff, like, in Kausep's montage videos, is he out-levels the opponent. It's not necessarily that he does something that is unresistible. In some cases, he does, but don't ever think that, like, every time he does this, that it'll work out the way that it does. Some of it, the opponents just fall victim to the leveling game.
That makes sense. Yeah, that seems like a lot of what playing Yi would be about.
Yeah, it's a leveling game. Yi is like playing poker. Every time he beats Riven, though, is pretty fucking impressive. That's full skill. Like, every time he beats a Riven, that's, like, really sick. But, like, stuff like this, like, doing the Riven combos the way that they're doing it, like, there's ways to do it where Kausep just would not be able to respond.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah.
Ooh, that was nice.
That was nice, yeah. Here, like this, right here, like against Vi and Blitzcrank. You have to know this is the result. And you always want to use, like, Q, like, if you think they're going to flash, like, use it when you think they're going to flash so that you follow them.
Yeah, you get to follow them.
Right. He fucked up, you see? You can see it on his face. Like, even though Twisted Fate went over there, he could have been able to follow if you timed the alpha right. In some of these clips, he's really fed, but for the most part, Yi is almost always able to do shit like this. But anyways, like, watch that VOD here. You can just search it. Kausep's montage number 2, right?
Yeah.
Like, just watch that on your own. And, like, learn some of the stuff that he's doing. Okay. So, here. We're gonna go into this game. Okay, let me open this up really quick.
Okay.
Oh, fuck. Did I say playing poker is like playing poker? I thought I said playing Yi is like playing poker.
No, I heard playing Yi is like playing poker.
That's what I heard. That's what I thought I said. Okay, let me open up Epic Pen. Okay. Ow, fuck my arm. Okay. Alright, let's just go to some stuff. Okay, so,
He feels a lot like Irelia. Really? No, in terms of... he's relatively simple to play and get the basics down, but there's so much outplay potential that if you really master I'm not saying you do the same thing as jungle Irelia as you master Yi, but they're similar in that sense.
Right.
They're simple with outplay potential.
He's more self-mechanically demanding, like on the keyboard, than Irelia. Irelia is more foresight demanding.
Okay.
Like, knowing how the burst and how all the trades will play out, and, like, pinging off minions and stuff with her Blade Surge. I think it's called Blade Surge, right?
Yeah.
Yi is much more about himself.
Okay.
Like, microing his abilities and timing them and everything like that. Yi is kind of like Ganon in Super Smash or something. Like, anyways. Let's just go forward. So, some stuff that I told you in the session that does not just apply to Yi. It's kind of like how, like, you go over to blue, you smite Gromp, etc., and then you just take the two small wolves, and then you
right.
do...
Right, just give you level 4.
That's, well, yes, but that's experience min-maxing. That is something that you can take from me telling you in this session and apply to every situation where something like that exists.
Okay.
Okay? So just, like, reverse engineer it. Fuck. Anyways, we just, so, like, okay, like, right here, like, you just, you can go into single player and practice this, but, like, you don't dodge, like, right there.
Yes.
Q. Right? And then, like, your Q would still be on cooldown or whatever.
Yeah.
And you W too early.
How, when do you want to W?
As the ball's about to hit you.
Okay. I'm assuming that lets you get two, or, like, one extra
fireball
of damage reduction.
So, you know, and, like, moving doesn't do anything. You're actually reducing your DPS.
But it makes you look cool.
No. Nope.
You wouldn't see a real swordsman fight a dragon standing still.
Anything else, Eric, that you... You having teleport here is, like, so funny. I mean, Flash? Not having teleport. Yeah, not having teleport. Fuck, that, like...
How did she know?
I don't know. I guess it has to be warded, like, in front of it.
I think what happened was Thresh came up. He was like, alright, I'm gonna help you, Master Yi, and then I think that's what tipped her.
Okay, let me just talk about something here. Like, right here, you should have alphaed onto,
Yes, alpha, then a couple autos of E.
Yeah, it would have given Katarina the reset, right? And then then you can go and do your little Wraith camp. The other thing is, like, here, you're not even watching, but the fight is still going on. Like, literally, like, you know, just let Yi auto-attack. Like, it doesn't, you know, like...
Right, yeah, once you hit that alpha, like, fuck it. I was in my own little world. I was checked out. And then Ziggs just shows up.
So, yeah. And then, like, right here, you can go on, I mean, you can check the movement speed, right? So, like...
Yes, that's something I should have definitely done. Just click him, check my movement speed. He probably would have been faster, but... Mm-hmm. You don't know unless you actually...
You don't know, right. And now you're just staying until level 6, so then we just zoom up. Okay? Like, right here, okay? This is where you said, like, go bottom.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? When you see this, like... Alright, so when you see this, you can just fucking...
Hold on, it's frozen. It's still at level 4, 645.
What? What do you mean it's frozen? Alright, let me restart screen share.
Yeah. Yeah, it looks fine on your stream, but on screen share, it's... Okay, this is better. Thank you.
Okay, you got it?
Yep.
Okay. So we're going to hit play. When you have this instance, like, you have to know, sort of like what I was talking about in the Cowsep stuff. Like, when you look bottom right here, like, you just need to know that when you hit here, like, Jesus. Okay. When you hit here, you're just beelining, like, straight to the second brush to, like, cut off, you know? And, like, you're just waiting to hit the Chilling Smite, E, and Q. But right. you're gonna R from this location. Always. Every single time, unless Graves is, like, pushing onto the tower, then depending at what angles he pushes, maybe your line is like this. But, like, for the most part, you're always going here, and this is the location that you will R. Every
Why
single
not
time.
R right away? Wouldn't that get me there faster? Or
no, because you're looking to maximize your R. Like, okay. The duration of it. You don't want to activate it until it's necessary, because you don't want it to wear off, possibly.
Gotcha.
Especially if you don't get the kills to reset.
Yeah. I guess, I was worried about Nasus, but...
Yeah, you shouldn't have been worried.
Who cares? And What's then, he like, gonna do?
Right here, like, There, I mean, there's two options here. You could have turned around, autoed him, and then if you auto, it reduces the cooldown, then you Q him and it dodges the ult. Alternatively, you turn on R and W here, right now. So, like, you hit R, but you hit W, you let the bomb hit, you Chilling Smite him, and you run. Like...
Okay.
There's so many ways out of this... You know, like, you didn't even W, so That's okay though.
Yeah, I was like, I'm getting out of here. See ya.
Here you were being a little too manly, but it's okay. Like, see, you didn't need to flash. Like, he was already on cooldown.
Yeah. And so, I think his auto attack was on, his, at least his cane was on cooldown too. So.
Yeah, his auto wouldn't kill you. And also, you W'd and the bomb wasn't even gonna hit you, so.
I know, I did it, sort of reflectively to stop my character.
Uh-huh.
Because apparently I'm not smart enough to press S.
Okay.
Gotta turn the brakes on.
So, alright. Like, right here, like, this is where you hunt for blood. It's coming up. Alright, it's coming up. Sorry, I have, like... Okay, what the fuck is this? Oh, okay, right here. Or, wait, what? Yeah, just fuck her up. No, chill... You probably know now that she was dead.
Yes.
Like, now...
Now that I have experienced the brokenness that is Yi when he's in melee range,
it's a great,
but in the
right?
moment, I was like, crap, Nidalee, what do I do?
But, you should have been able to kill her and then also go on Vel'Koz. But, no, yeah, there was a few instances where it's like, right here, like, okay, this is where I was screaming Quadra.
Yes, I can see this, Jing.
Turn on alt. Had you kept chasing and you turn on alt plus Wuju style?
Yes, I didn't even hit either.
It's okay. Yeah, E is free mana, so... Just...
Yeah, that's just something to get used to. Sort of like, I don't know, Kayle's ultimate is free mana.
Mm-hmm.
Zero cost.
Okay. Oh, sorry, Jesus. I'm, like, eating a fucking M&M. Alright.
I could tell. It's alright. They're good M&Ms.
Yeah. Great. Alright. So at this point, it just kind of becomes repetitive.
Yes.
It's basically the same shit. Nothing really stood out. You just need to question yourself on stuff that you're doing. Yi's okay. build is almost always the same. If they had, like, a Lissandra in mid lane, and they also have, like, another heavy AP champion, I wouldn't have you go Yumu's. I would probably just have you go... Well, it depends on who the... If it is a Lissandra, and they have something weird that's obnoxious, like a Morgana or something, I'll probably tell you to get a Scimitar. You know okay. what I mean? Because the Quicksilver
the
Smash.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Alternatively, you'll just get more of Malmortis.
Okay.
And then you go from there. Like, right here, like, this is easy. Like, see, like, you're hesitating. Like, kill him, turn on E, smite Vel'Koz, auto, he's dead already, right? You turn around, you mm-hmm. make it to Ziggs, your Q's off cooldown. Like, okay, so let's go through this in, like, slow mode. How do I slow it down? Okay. So, like, from right here, right? This is where you were, okay?
Mm-hmm.
You hit R, you come up here, Q, okay? With, like, an auto attack, okay? With your R being active. Your Q would almost be reset. Turn on to him, you chilling smite, so you smite, okay? And Q, you kill him. You turn, Q's gonna come off cooldown, like, Bork's up as well, and you'd Q and kill Ziggs, triple kill. Really, really easy every single time. Every single fucking time. Triple kill. Instantaneous.
Yep. I can see that. Easy peasy. And Riven lives.
Yep. I mean, you can even technically Penta. Yeah, you could Penta. You could Penta, yeah. But it's okay. And then everything else here just becomes repetitive shit and everything. And then we've already addressed the Baron. Like, why Thresh is an idiot.
Yep.
No need to risk the Baron. It's actually a risk not to do the Baron Thresh. I don't know if you'll ever see this video, Thresh, but...
Probably not.
Probably won't. Well, no, actually, you'd be surprised by how sometimes some of the people in the videos of people that I coach, like, they actually add me on Skype to be like, hey, I was that guy in that video once. I'm like, well... So... Okay, and then you'll just kind of keep this up, but yeah, just cheese your way into Diamond to get over the cognitive bias that you're having right now between Diamond 5 and Platinum, because I know it exists. Like,
okay.
But yeah, just cheese your way into Diamond 5 by doing shit like this. Take Teleport on Yi, not Flash. And then, like, yeah, just learn your map awareness and other stuff.
Okay, so Yi, general playstyle.
Yeah.
Pre-6, mainly focus on farm. Only really go after lanes if it's stupidly obvious you'll get a kill.
Yeah.
Level 6, same thing sort of, except with your ultimate, your kill potential is greatly increased. Mm-hmm. So you can start more actively looking for opportunities. And then going into the mid to late game, you're mainly focused on split pushing.
Yes.
Okay, sounds easy enough.
Hold on, I'm typing you his runes and masteries. Okay. Okay.
Yep, got them.
All right, got them. Okay, great. And then let me know how you're doing, and in a few days, let's just like talk or something. How often are you playing League right now? Like, how many games are you gonna continue to play this night?
Probably a few more games tonight.
Okay, then get into promos. Just get into promos, and then get Diamond 5 within like 3 days. Not hard.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
Like, I know I'm saying that, and maybe it's not totally getting through to you, but, like, you just need to go into those games as if they're already won, and that you just have to go through the hassle of playing them. That needs to be your mentality.
Okay.
Okay. All right. I will talk to you. I'll talk to you later then, okay?
All right. Thank you so much.
Later. Right, bye, man. Bye. Key.